Today on Internet Marketing Pro, how to staff a startup with almost no money. Are you legally minimizing your future tax burden and staying compliant in today's complex tax code? If not, our sponsor, Michelieu Consulting, has over 30 years of experience providing top quality professional services in accounting and tax preparation for a wide variety of clients just like you. Whether you need tax return filing, planning, bookkeeping, financial statements, full service payroll, or corporate or individual tax return filing, I personally recommend because I use them myself to contact Jeffrey Ressler, CPA at 561-237-5264. That number again is 561-237-5264. And you can visit his website at jrcpa.net. That's jrcpa.net. Tell Jeff that Chad Deckard sent you from this podcast to receive a special rate for listening to the show. Thank you very much. Broadcasting from the city of sun and rain off the Atlantic Ocean in Boca Raton, Florida. Good morning, good evening, wherever you may be across the nation and around the world. I'm your host, Chad Deckard, and welcome to my Internet Marketing Pro podcast show. My shows will cover how to grow your business as well as topics on tips, tricks, and techniques, digital lifestyles, the future of finance, and entrepreneurism. Thank you for tuning into my show as we begin this adventure together exploring many great things to come. Now, let's cover a quick few announcements before we get started. As I say before every program I get into, I show my gratitude and a real appreciation for all the feedback that I've been getting and what a difference it makes. It motivated me to put these shows out and continually think of the next subject matter that I'd like to explore with you all. And coming, you know, upon subject matters, I really want to hear from you, from looking at all the shows that I've done over the last 8 months of, you know, producing this show. I've had to come up with a lot of subject matters myself or from different people who sent me emails behind the scenes. But I want you all to step forward, start posting your reactions to my videos in the comments section. I'd love for you to flag it as far as thumbs up, like on YouTube, or star it, you know, if you see it on iTunes. Give me 5 stars, please. And please do a rating and review and subscribe, of course. You know, if you like my show and find it resourceful, you know, please do your social network a favor and share, like, post, leave a comment, and subscribe to my show. I greatly appreciate your efforts and support. And now, as you know, I am going to 3 days a week. That's Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. I'm publishing 3 shows, and I am going to step up the pace because I am highly motivated, and I hope you'll help me build my audience even bigger. And to do that, I'm going to need more reputation and frequency of my show in order to take it to the next level. And I really need your help because, remember, you are what makes this show a success. Now, let's get down to the business of what today's show is all about. It's kind of a two-part show. It's how to staff a startup with almost no money. And especially in these times of tight budgets and no money to be funded or small business loans like they used to, in this strapped economy, more and more people are trying to find ways to bring down their costs and leverage their work effort to the lowest denominator and be able to get the most leverage out of, you know, whatever they can. And that's why I produced this program, is to address that issue and try to find some kind of resolution or means to be able to help those who are seeking more help but really don't have the money to do it. So let's dive into, this subject matter. You know, struggling entrepreneurs around the world are in deep envy of Nick. It's kind of hard to say his last name. It's De Eliezo, a business acumen. You know, last month, you know, the 17-year-old sold a Sumly, which is a mobile app. It's a news aggregation app, to Yahoo for a reported $30 million. And if and when Nick starts another company, it will certainly be, and put it mildly, very well funded. Of course, most entrepreneurs do not have access to this kind of cash or resources, and the average business takes years to break even, let alone post a profit. Two-time entrepreneur Jordan Eisenberg, founder of Urgent RX, warns that few things in a startup are more important than carefully managing cash. At the beginning, you have investors. It is not unusual for you and possibly the employees to forego salary or extended periods of time so you might not get paid. And you do whatever it takes to build your product and get it to market. While the founders of a company might be willing to forego a paycheck for months on end to get their business up and running, their employees may not be so eager to make that sacrifice. So to get workers to go along with the cash-strapped entrepreneurs, they have to be creative in the way they think and how they hire. So here's some ideas that I've come upon to kind of help you come up with a resolution to this problem. My first one is non-monetary incentives. Many startups simply do not have the money for any kind of traditional compensation plan. And that's why so many entrepreneurs try to leverage equity. Taking on co-founders and compensating employees with a stake in the company can be a viable and initial fix, but it isn't always sustainable. Fortunately, there are other low or no-cost alternatives to get people to do work on your startup. Startup Digest, for instance, champions the curator model. And the company finds talented individuals to manage or curate the digest for their home cities. Curators receive no final financial compensation, yet management insists volunteers line up to lend a hand. Why? Well, because the platform lets curators distribute digests in their own names. It's a win-win transaction in which no money changes hands. As long as a curator is not a potential competitor, it allows collaborators to self-promote and leverage the company's Rolodex in exchange for some form of labor. When an employee or partner wants to spend his or her time performing tasks you need done, the need for monetary compensation can drop out of the equation. Colleges and universities can also provide free labor in the form of interns, offering mentorship in exchange for help at the office, and it can pay dividends, especially since college students can bring a deep grasp of social media and other technology chops that make them capable of much more than just making coffee these days. Another way to subsidize this startup dilemma with having no money is life hacks. Yes, life hacks, more popular than ever. How can we not just hack computers, but hack life in itself? And sometimes startups need to hire real paid employees to land high caliber talent at a rate that you can afford. Make your startup worthy of others' personal investment. Life hacks don't cost a lot of money, but can make working at a startup more desirable than better paying position at a staid old guard firm, you know, just the old boring stuff. You know, Silicon Valley companies like Google and Facebook are well known for providing employees with everything from in-house chefs to daycare. You know, those are expensive, but there are other tactics available, and those are flexible scheduling. You know, startups aren't just 9-to-5 jobs, so they let employees come in when they want. I know in my early part of my career working in Atlanta, Georgia, due to the high traffic, and I know many of you out there like LA, Chicago, New York, know exactly what I'm talking about. Many firms have flex schedules where you can come in and choose what's best for you. You know, if you're an early bird and you want to get into work at 6 and leave by, basically 2 or 3 because you're going to pick up kids at the work. There's all kinds of schedules like that. So those are kind of really great incentives to be flexible around people's schedule. It's not always about the money. It is about the quality of life. The other way of doing it is remote working. You know, forget Marissa Mayer. If employees are productive at home, let them work from there when they need to. At least they won't leave work and go, you know, work at Yahoo. So, you know, let people work at home. That is another really great incentive is to telecommute. And if you have a really good employee that you trust and knows a producer, you know, give them that slack. That's worth a lot. Sometimes that's a good way to give them a raise is give them a little slack, you know, instead of money. And the other one would be public recognition. Praise in front of others for our efforts is an innate human need. Leverage it to build loyalty. You know, you need to focus on offsetting lower wages with fun, engaging, and accommodating perks that don't cost the company a lot of money. It's the best way to compete with or for the talent that you need in today's economic times and competition. Not every candidate will sign on to the vow of poverty to work for your company, but there are people out there ready to take a bit less in order to become part of something really special and something that they feel passionate about as well. And my final, I'd say, way to save money on your startup is I have a firm, and if you want, refer to the description of this video or audio, depending on how it's being delivered to you, and go into the description of it, of this particular program. I have a link there. And it will take you to a company that I had on here several weeks ago that I interviewed. It was Derek Brown at Pronto. And that link will take you to Pronto, to a form. I ask you to fill out the web form. And, you know, what's really great about Derek is he's the one who launched Microsoft in Thailand. He has an extraordinary company that I... I'm going to be using here very shortly. I've got a number of people I'm putting onto this particular service, but he is able to, at a very low cost, manage your total internet presence. You need articles written, you need PR, you need a website done, you need someone to set up and manage all your social networks and post for you, and on and on and on, send your emails, develop your emails. He can do all that, believe it or not, for under $250 a month. You can't beat that. Not only that, it's highly ranked service. Several of my friends turned me onto it. They swear by it. They've been with the company almost from the start for about 4 to 5 years. So I highly recommend checking out my description, clicking that link and filling out the form. And that's about all I'm going to cover in this program. I hope that you got a great deal of information that will help you in solving your problem in not having enough money or resources with your startup to be able to staff it properly. But don't forget all the points that I made. They will definitely help you in the future, hopefully get to the origin of success that you really want to achieve. So if you like my show, please feel free to share it with your social network. And share, like, post, leave a comment, and subscribe to my show. I greatly appreciate your efforts and support. And remember, you know, you are part of what makes this show a success. Well, good morning, good evening, wherever you may be, across the nation and around the world. This is Chad Deckard signing off. Goodbye for now.